Most people who come here, when they look at me, they think it's not an indigenous tree. Like this is a native of this forest. It's one of the trees that we cut for timber during those days when we steal forest.
Robert Barijire has lived around Bwindi impenetrable forest since he was born. He has seen natural trees being depleted and over the years has cultivated a passion for them. His mission now is to restore the oldest indigenous species of trees that ever existed in Uganda. He works with the Institute of Tropical Forest Conservation.
Those thousands of trees I have told you are planted outside there so that quickly explains people's dependence on the forest is reducing. With the time, when these trees are fully established, there will be no more going into the forest for the indigenous trees.
A dollar buys 12 seedlings.
Currently now I am selling bamboo from my own garden instead of coming to get from the forest. I also planted some medicinal plants. These days, I see my neighbors and my own family using those trees, especially those which have like medicinal value for livestock. One of them is Hagenia abyssinica.
And so far we have sold a couple of good seedlings to these local communities at very low subsidized prices. You are talking of around 6,000 tree species, but you are still propagating more which are being planted. And this also helps with climate change, you know, a way of climate change in the area. So as we plant more woodlots, we are also trying to help in climate change mitigation, and also the community is sustainably harvesting from the forest without destroying the forest.
Bwindi has 163 species of trees covering 331 square kilometers. It's also home to 400 mountain gorillas, that's half of the world's population.
This is Podocarpus latifolius. It's one of the most sought-after indigenous species of trees. And it has many uses, from timber to carving and even medicine. From the nursery here, it will take about 5 months before it's ready to be sold out. And after, it can take over 20 years to mature.
Raising a seed, you first of all, you get them from the forest. Then you dry them. After drying them, like you make a nursery bed, then you put them there for like a month or two.
Uganda has recorded a slight increase in the national forest cover from 9% in 2015 to 12.4% now, a report by the National Forestry Authority shows. The improvement is being attributed to continuous tree planting. Razia Athman,